And first speaker today is Dmitry Korikov, St. Petersburg Department of the Steklov Institute. Please.
Thanks to organizers for the opportunity to speak here. My talk is based on our joint works with Mikhail Igorovich Belyashev. Let's begin. Let M be a compact surface with...
Коллеги, а тут вот онлайн ничего не слышно. Это нормально?
Так, у меня все горит зеленым.
А меня слышали?
Слышно, слышно, все, слышно.
Спасибо. Громче.
Окей. Let M be a compact surface with boundary gamma and metric tensor G. Denote UF a solution of the Laplace equation in interior of the surface M with trace F on the boundary gamma. The operator that maps F to the normal derivative of UF on gamma is called Dirichlet-Neumann map, DN map. The question on the electric impedance tomography is, to what extent does Dirichlet-Neumann map determine the surface? It contains four sub-questions: a uniqueness, a construction of solutions, a characterization of DN maps, and a stability of solutions. The question on uniqueness answered by Lasash and Ullmann. Let MG and M prime G prime be surfaces with joint boundary gamma. Then their DN maps coincide if and only if there is a conformal map between them, which does not move points of the boundary gamma. So the DN map determines not the surface, but only its conformal class. Next, by a solution of the EIT problem, we mean any surface M prime with given boundary gamma and given Dirichlet-Neumann map lambda. Such a solution is a conformal copy of the original surface M. The next question is how to construct such a copy from DN map. Here, the crucial question is which objects can be used as points of a copy. The answer proposed by Mikhail Igorovich Belyashev is the following. In capacity of the points, one can use multiplicative linear functionals on a certain commutative algebra A related to a surface. Recall that a multiplicative linear functional on algebra is called a character. The set A hat of all non-zero characters is called the spectrum of the algebra A. Each element of A is realized as the function eta hat by the following rule. This function is called the Gelfand transform of the element eta. There is the canonical Gelfand topology on the spectrum in which all Gelfand transforms are continuous. If the algebras A and B are isomorphic, then their spectra are homeomorphic. The key instrument is the surface algebra A of M, which consists of all holomorphic continuous functions on the surface M. Endowed with the supremum norm, this algebra is Banach. The key fact is that All its non-zero characters are Dirac measures delta x of points x of the surface. Moreover, the map x to delta x is a homeomorphism from the surface M onto the spectrum of the algebra A of M. Also, due to the maximum principle, the algebra A of M is isometrically isomorphic to the trace algebra A of gamma, which consists of all traces of holomorphic functions on the boundary gamma. Due to this, the spectrum of the trace algebra A of gamma is homeomorphic to the spectrum of the algebra A of M. And therefore, it is homeomorphic to the spectrum, it is homeomorphic to the original surface M. Due to these facts, the construction procedure is the following. Determine the trace algebra A of gamma from the Dn map lambda by the following formula. Then take its spectrum as a homeomorphic copy of the surface M. Next, the Gelfand transforms of elements of the trace algebra are copies of holomorphic functions on the surface M. Due to this, the Gelfand transforms provide a biholomorphic atlas on the spectrum. And with this atlas, the spectrum is a biholomorphic and therefore conformal copy of the surface M. This copy is a solution of the EIT problem. Now, let's move on to our recent results. The first one is the extension of the scheme above to the case of non-orientable surfaces. First, we provide the following criteria of orientability of the surface in terms of its Dn map. Next, suppose that the surface M is non-orientable. Then there are no holomorphic functions on M except constants. However, holomorphic functions do exist on the orientable double cover of the surface M. Roughly speaking, the cover is the surface whose points are pairs XO, where X is the point of the surface M and O is a local orientation at the point X. The matrix on the cover.
So you mean that O is plus minus one?
Yeah. Locally. Okay. And the matrix on M is determined in such a way that the projection P from XO to X is a local isometry from the cover to the surface M. An example, an orientable double cover of a Möbius strip is a surface of a cylinder. So we have the double cover and we determine the trace algebra of the cover using only Dn map of the original surface. Then we construct the copy of the cover and therefore the copy, the conformal copy of the original surface M. The similar result is the extension to the case of surfaces with internal holes. The boundaries of holes are unknown. they are electrically isolated or grounded. As the inverse data, we have only DN map on the external component of the boundary. The scheme of solving is similar. The difference is that now the double cover is a surface obtained by gluing two copies of the surface M along the boundaries of internal holes. Okay. The next question is a characterization of DN maps. Suppose that lambda is a linear operator acting on smooth functions on the closed curve gamma. The question is lambda a DN map of some orientable surface with the boundary gamma? To give a characterization is to provide necessary and sufficient conditions for this. And the one form of such conditions is obtained by Henkin and Michel in terms of multidimensional complex analysis. In our work, we provide the another necessary and sufficient conditions in algebraic terms. Let's take a look on the theorem. As we can see, our conditions are quite complicated, but their origins are simple. First, each condition represents some property of holomorphic functions on the surface. Namely, we introduce the following operator G, we construct it from lambda. If lambda is a DN map of some surface, then the kernel of G is the set of traces of all holomorphic functions on the surface. The operator G is the operator that checks Cauchy-Riemann conditions on the boundary, if lambda is the Dirichlet-Neumann map. The condition one represents the fact that the set of holomorphic functions is an algebra. The condition two is an argument principle expressed in the algebraic terms, and so on. Second, our conditions include only the operator lambda and G, and the operator G, and these conditions are meaningful even if no surface is present. And finally, if our conditions are satisfied, then they provide the algebra A, which is the kernel of the operator G, the algebra A whose spectrum is a required surface, such that lambda is its Dirichlet-Neumann map. Here, the crucial question is how the structure of a surface appears on the spectrum of commutative Banach algebra. The answer is provided by the classical Bishop Aupetit-Vermeer theorem on analytic structure, which is the key fact in the proof of sufficiency of our conditions. Finally, we deal with the stability question. Is the surface M prime close to the surface M if its Dirichlet-Neumann map lambda prime is close to Dirichlet-Neumann map lambda of the surface M? Here, the crucial question is How to compare the surfaces M prime and M. In our work, we provide the following simple way for this. We compare not the surfaces, but images of their holomorphic immersions, E and E prime in CN. As a measure of closeness of images, we mean the Hausdorff distance between them, which is the infimum of positive R, such that R neighborhood of the first image contains the second one, and R neighborhood of the second image contains the first one. We have proved the following. Suppose that the surface M and its holomorphic immersion E are fixed. If the surface M prime is homeomorphic to the surface M and its Dirichlet-to-Neumann map lambda prime is close to lambda in the operator norm, in the following operator norm, then there is a holomorphic immersion E prime whose image E prime of M prime is close to the image E of M in Hausdorff distance. In other words, the following convergence is valid. That's all result. That's all the results. Thank you for your attention. I just comment the conditions in the characterization theorem. The first condition represents the property that the holomorphic functions form an algebra. The second condition is the argument principle in algebraic terms. The condition number three is a version of the divisor theorem on the surface. What is the condition number four? If the surface is not simply connected, then we have the harmonic functions, which are not real parts of holomorphic functions. The factor space of harmonic functions over real parts of holomorphic functions is a double number of handles on the surface. Here we state that the number of handles is finite. I have enough time. Property number four is the following. If we have two holomorphic functions, then zeta over eta in general is not a holomorphic function, it has the poles. But if the polynomial of zeta over eta is a holomorphic function, then eta over zeta is a holomorphic function too. Okay. Thank you.
Okay, let's thank the speaker for the talk. Questions, comments, remarks?
Дим, можно the holes in your surface.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah. You mean, do you know a priori what conditions are on the boundary of holes?
We don't know about the types of the boundary conditions, but we reconstruct a copy with.
So they can be different. Or either Neumann or Dirichlet.
Okay. Now we can deal with the different types of the conditions on the different holes. In the first work, we deal with the first or second conditions on all holes, but we don't know about what is the type of the conditions.
Okay, thank you.
You have called one of this boundary circle by gamma and another called by interior holes.
Yes, we.
The conditions are dependent on the
exterior bound. Yes, yes.
What will happen if you rename the person you will call by gamma or some of the interior circles?
If I understand you, the procedure is the same.
And the result,
now we can consider the problem for which the Dirichlet-Neumann map is given on a part of the boundary, on a segment of the boundary. The scheme of solving is similar. We construct the cover, gluing all other parts of boundary to its copy. Okay.
More questions?
Are there any other results for stability for other cases of compareness for surfaces?
Our results or results of another people?
Maybe other people or yours.
Now we improve the stability result given here, but we have not completed.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, so we almost have no time. So let's thank Peter again.